There's so many other great Chicago Bears players. Obviously, you've been one of the great, not the greatest of all. What's your fondest memory of being a Bear?
Well, I guess just being a member of what I would consider pro football is. I was always in the football since an early age. I know the kids now, they see that TV. But I was a stone cold football freak. I did everything geared to play the game from the time I was getting married, when I should get married, everything was plotted all around football. And I never followed the Bears that much because we were from the south side. The Cardinals were playing the University Park back then. But to know my background and then to play for a guy like George Halas, who started it, virtually started the NFL for football, it was like, I don't know, but it would be like you're a new group and you get to work with the Beatles or something. You know, it was. And that's probably it. I mean, the reputation, the fans of that city, I know every city has the best fans, but those people in Chicago put up a lot of crappy years, and they're smart fans. They know what's going on. And you can tell by what the defense that were busting their ass, and they appreciated that, and they would give it to the offense a bunch of crap because they were so dead-head. But no better. I don't care. I hear everybody, oh, this is the greatest city, this and that. When you talk about the history of where football came from, I mean, come on. The monsters are a bit of a hot. It's tough to beat that. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
What player, maybe he's retired already or he's currently playing, but what player comes to mind that reminds you most of that 25 or 26-year-old Dick Butkus?
Well, I would say Michael Kingley right off the bat, not because we're over here. he was an award winner here, and he was one of my award winners. He just seems like he's a no bullshit kid. He looks like he's 100% to play football, and that's what it's all about. And it's sad to see him get that concussion, but as time goes by, things starts happening. But so he's been fortunate to get by any major things, and I just hope he's okay to continue because. If I'm watching the Bears or the Bears aren't playing, I'll watch the defense of the Panthers or any of the other ones that my guys won the award. So it's like I mentioned about Urlacher when he was playing and they were like, Carpenter's about how good he was and everything. And I said, when you watch him, he grabs people. He's quick and he grabs tackles. I'm thinking of guys that really, hit. I mean, I was a fullback in high school and a linebacker, and what really bugged me was when someone hit me high, wrapped their arms around my arms, and I started to fall, and I had nothing to break my fall with. I can't get my hands loose. And maybe sometimes if I try to get my hand loose, I might just happen to have the ball, and there goes a fumble. And I thought, this is the way I'm going to do it. And so I did that in high school. Then in college, these guys are going to be better now. It's going to be harder for me to do it. Well, lo and behold, it wasn't that bad. And then when I got to the pros, these guys are the best. And lo and behold, some of these guys got that yellow streak down their back. They're looking where they're going. Just, why don't you tell me where you're going? Still just looking there, So there's a Cleveland Clinic in Vegas. And what they do is they have a thing through the Players Association that if you've been out maybe up to 10 years, they'll do a head deal for you and all that stuff, see your concussion. So a friend of mine got, who's going there for his Parkinson's, he got me in there. So I went through the brain scan, they sent us the results to Cleveland Clinic in Ohio, and then they would wire it back, and they all look at it. This is shortly after I saw that Webster concussion deal. So then I got to talk to a psychiatrist, and then when I went to the physical trainer, she says my balance was worse than my buddy with Parkinson's disease. That was a real lift. But I think that was correctable by doing these exercises, you know, falling all over the place. So after the second day, you go see this main doctor for the results. So I walk in there, and he's looking at the, let's see, here's a brain scan. And he said, he said, this is amazing. I said, what's up? He says, this is like, it's almost like normal. And I'm like, what the hell does that mean? It's like a surprise. It's almost normal. No, I said, no. I mean, because of your reputation, the way you hit, I would have suspected you'd have a lot more problems. And I said, well, maybe it was the way I hit. I would hit that high. And so it must have worked. Because, I started thinking I had something, I'd forget something. But shit, I'm 73 years old. I got neuropathy and arthritis. And as long as my brain's all right, to let me know that I'm really messed up physically, I'm okay. It's sad to see some of these guys, though. Sad.
You mentioned the new concussion. Talk to us a little bit about some of the injuries that you guys had. Were there a lot of concussions during your time?
Well, first of all, they weren't called concussions. My very first game is probably what I would sustain the one and only time that I was like knocked out. I got kicked right square in the head, and as a rookie, I was playing the second and fourth quarters. So we're at Washington, and I went in the blitz, and I must have gotten kicked or whatever. And so I'm on the sidelines, and George Yellen's like, okay, you all right? I said, yeah, I'm all right. Where are we going to start? It's the fourth quarter. I said, yeah, it's cool. But that was the only time. And, of course, Bowling County thinks, bullshit, you had a lot of them, probably. But the knees were good, right? Because, you have a knee operation back then, you're in a cast. Is it this, you're playing after a little cartilage deal 4 weeks later. But medical advances and the nutrition advances, now compared to when back in those days, it's leaps and bounds, it's another century. Shit, if I had that, was able to take advantage of all that stuff, I'd still be playing.
What was the closest time you came to coaching in the NFL?
It didn't happen because I thought it was going to happen. I was very naive. I thought at the end I was going to end up with the Bears in some capacity. It's all I ever did. Only thing I ever knew, I still got the old 16-millimeter projector that went back and forth, back and forth. But what had happened, I'm trying to make this short, what had happened during the war, they were giving a lot of no-cut contracts to these players on one document. So I had my first deal was 5 years. It was on one document. And my attorney, the one good thing he did was the last paragraph he put in there that no matter what happens or if I don't have the skill to play professional football, I shall receive the amount, which was in paragraph 4, that was your shall. Owners got smart. Then they started saying, my next contract was for 3 years. He said, we're going to give you a 3-year no cut. Oh, really? Okay. Well, why are you giving me 3 individual contracts? Well, it was so that if you signed all 3 of the contracts and if you got hurt the first year, the 2 other ones were null and void. That's how they got away from giving no cuts. But they didn't take out that last paragraph from my first contract that said, no matter what said, what happens, he gets paid. And then it went through another 4-year contract. It was over after the first year, but doctor should never have passed me my physical. I was sneaking out. You couldn't go to the other doctor, so I was sneaking out every Friday night. And I went to Mayo Clinic, I went to Johns Hopkins, I went to the University of Florida, I went to Atlanta. Everybody telling me the same thing. You gotta have a tibial osteotomy where they take a wedge out of your tibia, virtually make you knock me. And when I told the doctor that, he says, oh, you'll be the first one to play because I put any staples in there to hold it together. And I said, great. But so I thought I was gonna be a coach, and then the old man just said, we're not going to pay you. If you don't play, we're going to, you know, we're not going to pay you. I said, well, what about the contract? He says, sue us. That's what I had to do. And they delayed it 2 years. I was interviewed for Monday night with Cosell and them guys, and I couldn't do it because I was attacking the league with my suit. So then, after 2 years, they said, okay. My attorney flies me, and I go back to Chicago, and I said, you know, to my attorney, what did it cost the Bears to go through all this bullshit for the last 2 years? And he said, hundreds of thousands of dollars. And that wasn't even, that wasn't anywhere close to what they owed me on my old contract. And I was going to give that up and take half, because coaches didn't make more than players. And they just laughed at it. Like, it really ticked me off when the one attorney said, well, hey, Leo, how would you like to try this case? And he started cracking up. He said, I'm going to touch this case with a 10-foot pole. Well, that was the Bears lawyer. And I'm sitting there thinking, wow, you son of a, here's somebody who wants to get into the football, and you guys running after the fees, preventing me from doing what I wanted to. Because you know, you gotta make your money and everything else, and after 2 years you knew you didn't have a chance to win. And I said, well, that's business for you. Not the right way to do it. But what am I gonna do, man? Football was my deal. Heaven's the bit. I mean, I wasn't a Rhodes Scholar. I mean, I took all classes pertaining to football, physical education. And I'm still in sort of the health business with my EBC scanner, my wellness center. So, you know, like my wife always said, when one door closes, the other will open. So it worked out in hindsight, probably better, because I probably would be put in jail trying to coach some of these kids.
Well, as we know, we had a lot of fun today. We got one last question. Who is the best linebacker ever to play in the NFL?
Well, what am I supposed to say? Here's a better way to look at it. You think of anybody who you think he is, and then you tell me how many Hall of Famers are in front of him, on the side of him, behind him, on the defense.
I think that answers the question, right?